there's just a little bit of grease and there is a little bit of crumbs. So that's kind of nice because what I have right here are some sliced tomatoes. So what I'm adding to that skillet are some sliced tomatoes. Here are our finished... Hi, I'm Betty. Welcome to Betty's Kitchen. Today we're making rice cooker. Just measure out 1/2 cup and put it in, and then add it. I got my 1/4 cup water. We'll go in the mix. We need some lemon juice. If I had some fresh lemons, I would squeeze some fresh lemon juice. Let me start again on that. I'm getting ready to Welcome to Betty's Kitchen. Today we're making soup can pasta. And this is a recipe that I made up for some of you that had requests such as the following. You wanted something that was quick. It had to be easy. It had to be something that would not fail. You don't have to know how to cook in order to do it. It had to be something... Let's start again. So we thought we'd go down and see the falls today. And we picked today in particular because Cumberland Falls is one of about 2 or 3 falls. And Cumberland Falls is kind of special because it's one of 2 places in the world where you can see a moonbow. And a moonbow is just like a rainbow, only it's not at night. We just finished our lunch here at the River View. Is that what it is?
River View.
Sorry. We just finished our lunch here at the Riverview restaurant, and what we're going to do is go out and... Hi, I'm Betty. Welcome to Betty's Kitchen. Here we are at I'm going to continue with my spaghetti with homemade meat sauce. It's not meat sauce. But this is really what you want when you make banana bread, or anything that involves baking a dough that has bananas in it that are mashed up. Now this one looks a little bruised. So here I am back in the kitchen and I have my basil and I have taken what I need of it and chopped it up here. So I want to tell you the recipe that we're making. We're making spinach pesto linguine. No, it was fettuccine. Here I am back in the kitchen, and I have my basil that I got from the herb garden, so that will come up later. But I want to tell you the recipe that I'm making today. I'm making spinach pesto. Here I am back in the kitchen, and I have some basil that I brought from the herb garden, and I want to tell you the recipe that we're going to make. We're going to make spinach pesto linguine. We're ready to continue with our spicy black bean. And I do want to say one thing about the chopping. You might wonder why I'm going to chop it and then blend it. And those are the giblets. So there is the neck, and also there will be a liver, a heart, and maybe some other organ. Now I don't want it to smoke or anything like that. It doesn't have to be extremely hot. In fact, what I'm going to do is put 1/2 cup of almond halves. You can use whole almonds if you want. You can use these are cashews. So what I have here is 1/2 cup of cashew halves. There is a lot of flour that goes in here, and then we have our chocolate that I talked about earlier. That's my dog lying down in his house. So let's continue. I'm continuing to blend together let's start again. So here is the beautiful mixture that you get once you get those eggs incorporated And let me start. And here is a serving of our blue. We're going to use lemon juice. If you have fresh lemons, then you can squeeze 1 tablespoon of it, or this is just reconstituted lemon juice, which you can always keep on hand in your. Next, I'm going to add 1 tablespoon